Dallas, Texas. Fascinating architecture is the trademark of the skyline here. And just due east of downtown, the Cotton Bowl is a landmark. At the Texas State Fairgrounds, an overflow crowd has come for the 53rd edition of this postseason classic. Today, the Mobile Cotton Bowl brings together two teams from the top 10, the UCLA Bruins and the Arkansas Razorbacks.
Harry Foster will return for the Razorbacks. UCLA won the toss and selected to defer its option until the opening of the second half. So the Razorbacks will return. Barry Foster will receive the kick of Kirk Maggio. And Foster not excellent at kick returns, averaging under 20 yards per return. He's a terrific fullback, but that'll be irrelevant in this circumstance. It will open with Quinn Groby, the sophomore from Duncan, Oklahoma, as the quarterback. Barry Foster, the leading ground gainer. They use two fullbacks there. And Joe Johnson and Aaron Jackson are the running backs. Tim Horton, the wide receiver. The tight end, who doesn't catch many passes, is number 86, Billy Winston. In 12 years, 13 years, and you saw that Kobe is undefeated as a starter. Quick pass, left side. The pass is caught by Barry Foster. UCLA defense, led by a linebacking corps which is hampered by injuries. Doug Klein replaces the leading tackler, Chance Johnson. Craig Davis, the other inside linebacker. And Billy Ray replaces an injured Eric Smith. Carnell Lake at 200 pounds, not the biggest linebacker in collegiate football. Second down and 8. And a pure wishbone this time. Roby keeps and picks up a yard as they have a 3rd and 7 here. Groby scrambles and is dropped down at the 15-yard line. 13.3 yards per return with 2 for touchdowns. That's a line drive effort. And Henley bobbles the ball. Out of bounds. Who keeps it? Was it recovered or did it cross the sideline? UCLA ball. I don't have a doubt one. First and 10, UCLA. They operate with 3 men split to the left. Sean Wills opens in the backfield. So a new wrinkle by Terry Donahue. Aikman opens at quarterback. You know about him. Eric Ball, despite playing with an injured ankle, will start today. And he's joined at fullback by Mark Kestwick. The wide receivers, no speed here. More and far in the tight end, a dandy Charles Arbuckle. Ball and Estwick in the eye on 2nd down and 10. And an audible by Aikman. Eric Ball for a couple. Let's meet the secondary of this Razorback defense. Richard Brothers and Anthony Cooney are the corners. And the safeties, almost like twins, Patrick Williams and Steve Atwater. Right side. Eric Ball short of the first down. And UCLA will have to give it up. And Tim Horton is deep. Way up in the air. No fair catch call.
We have mercy.
Kick interference against the kicking team. 15-yard penalty at the first down.
Ken Hatfield in 5 years at Arkansas. 1st down and 10. Razorbacks after the 15-yard penalty. Foster hurdles over left tackle and gets out to the 38-yard line. It was Foster, of course, who had the 80-yarder in the Miami game. And he tests the middle this time, and that'll be close for the first down. 3rd and 1. Double tight end set. That'll be close. Joe Johnson, number 19, known as a conservative ball club. But Groby averages 9.9 yards per passing attempt. Here's Groby on the option going left. And Gilbert Crawford, multidimensional player, has operated at a lot of different positions. Mark Henry and James Morris, big key today because Freddie Childress, the all-conference guard, is out. Morris moves to his spot and Henry gets a start. Mabry at left tackle and Rick Opolskas at right tackle in 88. And he'll throw. Looks deep for Horton, settles for an alternate receiver. The pass incomplete, and a flag is down.
That was big guys who throw the ball downfield. Well, Quinn Grove.
Wishbone look in the backfield. And Grovey on a quarterback draw. That was a design play. And he's out to the 32-yard line. He's got a third and 17 here.
But he's got the best arm of all three of their quarterbacks.
Good pass protection. Deep right side. Picked off. Intercepted by Darrell Henley. And Henley has a UCLA ball at the 31-yard line. But no score in the ball game. That is the first turnover. Second UCLA possession. Eric Ball down at the 29-yard line. Second down and 8 UCLA. No score in the ball game. Blitz coming. Aikman on the spread out. Chased by Atwater. Lets it go. Caught at the 19-yard line. Sean Wills checks into the backfield. And again, the three wide receivers set to the left. Danny Thompson is in, makes the catch. And he's got on a first down pass play to the 16-yard line. The best of the bunch, Frank Cornish at center, number 68. Rick Meyer and Lance Zeno.
And Zeno needs to have a big game today against Michael Shepard.
Bobby Minifield and Bill Page.
And they've thrown two balls to them. They put him with three wide receivers on a side. They think he's going to get open quickly.
Backs in the eye. Option play. Aikman pitches. And Brian Brown is cut down. Three-man rush by the Razorbacks. Aikman intercepted, picked off at the 8-yard line. LaSalle Harper gets his second pick of the year. And Shepard's tip ball intercepted by LaSalle Harper. First down at the 11. Grovey still has it. Fakes the option, is knocked down at the 20 by Henley. Second down and 2, scoreless first quarter. And that will not be enough on third and a foot. Driven back, didn't get it. Jim Waller, the 13.3 yards per return. Waits at the 45. And this time he zoomed away from the ball. Waving his hand saying, I want no part of it. And ironically, I think finished what? Honorable mention? All Mac 10 this year?
Hard to figure out.
Isn't it though? From the 43, first and 10, draw play. Brian Brown pops it up the middle. McCracken and Keating are the new wide receivers now. They'll give it to the fullback, Mark Estrick.
We've got a dead ball, personal foul against the offensive team, 15-yard penalty.
Luther Anderson and the year before that, Mike Sherrard, or a couple of years. They don't have those kind of receivers, is what we mean. First down. Aikman. What a collision at the 39. All three play a lot. Second down and 20. Here comes Owens on the blitz. Left side caught by McCracken. What an interesting combination. McCracken is knocked down. And a loose ball? Or was he down? He was down. Third and 19, final 90 seconds, scoreless first quarter. Ball at the 46 of UCLA. Aikman down at the 45, loses a yard. Waits for it at the 15. Nice high fair catch called. And Horton grabs it at the 14-yard line. 359 yards and 88. Jackson. That's the end of the first quarter with the score 0-0. The Huddle Cotton Bowl on CBS Sports returns after this message. Second down and 9. Arkansas operating from their own 16. Grovey pulls up and lets it fly and overthrows Tim Horton. They have contained him. Third and 9. Grovey in trouble. Wiggles out of it. But is caught short of the first down at the 22-yard line. Jim Waller, number 6, early in the season for Henley. Rush coming. And Henley is going to have to chase this one. Meacham unloads a beauty. inside the 10 and out at the 7. First and 10, UCLA at the 7, following a 71-yard punt. Brian Brown across the 10 near the 12-yard line. Left side, almost picked off. Richard Brothers defending. Brian Brown, the intended receiver, has a 6-year-old son, as a matter of fact, who is not here. Third and 6. Four-man rush for the Razorbacks, and Aikman will keep it. And cannot pick up the first down. The flag is down.
We have a dead ball. Personal foul against the defense. 15-yard penalty. First down.
Earth tones. First and 10. UCLA first down. Brian Brown. And he is knocked down at the 35-yard line. And Sean Wills, the freshman, Danny Thompson, rather, checks in again. Sean Wills goes left side from the 41. Fullback, Estwick, appears to have enough to move the chain. This is a UCLA team that can run the ball with great effectiveness. You hear so much about Aikman, sometimes a tendency to ignore their ground game. Here's a play fake. Aikman looks for Thompson, and he's hit as he lets it go. Kerry Owens got the pressure. The other outside linebacker, also from Stuttgart, second and 10. Audible by Aikman. Brian Brown. The other 7 are foggy. I said that's appropriate. Third and 7. Blitz coming from Owens. Aikman on a line. Caught by Reggie Moore. First down, UCLA at the Arkansas 44th with a last-minute touchdown catch. Makes the grab. Brown in motion, wide left. Three-man Arkansas rush. Aikman, wide. Oh! Brian Brown. Brown gets a block from Estwick, but will be tackled at the 40-yard line. That brings up a third and long again. And he's hitting 64%, 63% on third downs. 64% overall for the year. Four-man Arkansas rush. Aikman sprints out. Lets it go. Caught by Mike Farr. And that's another UCLA first down. And Mark Estwick tripped. Second down and 8. Blitz coming. Aikman rolls to his left, has the option, and he'll keep it and fights down to the 21. Razorbacks corners come up. Now they drop back, and again it's a four-man rush. Aikman across the middle to Brown, has a first down. LaSalle Harper, first and 10 at the 16. No score. 7 minutes to go, first half. And Brown fights over right guard down near the 12-yard line. Second down and 7. Arbuckle in motion. Toss to Brown. Estwick with a block, and Brown has helmets fly off, is down at the 11-yard line. 33rd and 5. Scoreless first half. Aikman gets a terrific block. On a line to the 5, and McCracken is out of bounds with a first and goal at the 1. First and goal, UCLA. Estwick, touchdown, UCLA. That's just his third touchdown of the year. And the Bruins break the scoreless tie. But here's Velasco with the extra point.
Take a look at the center and the right guard, Cornish and Zeno, who do a nice job of clearing the way for Estwick. They get low, so there can be no penetration by the Razorbacks, and Estwick just dives into the end zone, and UCLA is up on top, 7-0.
71. Here's Kirk Maggio's kickoff. Barry Foster moves up and grabs it at the 5-yard line. Out to the 26. First and 10. Razorbacks. James Rouse. Second down at 8. Reverse. Derek Russell. Say hello to Marcus Patton. Maybe they could emulate Michigan State's Andre Rison on 3rd and 44 last night. There's a flag down, and the pass is incomplete into Washington State.
An offensive face mask. 15-yard penalty.
Go ahead. Henley back to return. Meacham's punt. And again, Meacham causes havoc for Darrell Henley. They drove 93 yards for the only touchdown of the ball game. Aikman thus far, 8 of 13 for 59 yards. After a play fake, he'll throw on first down, maybe gets rid of it. And a nice job by Sean Wills, number second down, 5. Estwich touchdown, the only score of the game. Corwin Anthony, the tight end, goes left. So does Sean Wills. And gets by Atwater, and then breaks another tackle, and is out of bounds. Up at the 46, Richard Brothers finally caught up with him on Arkansas. First down at the 46. UCLA leads 7-0, 3:13 to go in the first half. They'll plunge it up the middle with Maury Toy. Mind you, they're 9-2 coming in.
Kind of an indictment of how we all think about sports, isn't it?
Aikman rolls right. Goes deep across the middle, incomplete for his tight end. 9-15 for 64 yards. Third. They've converted 5 third downs in a row. Aikman. Oh, he had Anthony wide open down the middle. Settles instead for Paul Richardson, number 87. A seldom used third string wide receiver is Aikman to Paul Richardson. Corners playing way off as Aikman drops back. He settles right side for Maury Toy, the fullback. That is only the second catch of the season for Maury Toy. Second down and 3. Ball on the 21. Maury, no, it's Sean Wills. Big hole. Down to the 3-yard line and perhaps the 2. Had a terrific early start of the season. Now Toy and Brown in the backs. 1:25 to go. Danny Thompson starts in motion. They hand it to Toy and he picks up a yard. Estwick. Wills in the backfield behind Aikman. Sean Wills popped by LaSalle Harper. Wills and Danny Thompson check in. Thompson on a wing to the right. Estwick is the fullback. Third and goal with 27 seconds to go in the half. Fake. Aikman has two men open. One deep, caught tight end Corwin Anthony. Touchdown UCLA. Terrific job of a play fake by Troy Aikman.
And again, one of those subtle things. You think about Aikman throwing the ball downfield.
41 of 41 in the regular season. And 2 of 2 today.
Then he rolls out to the right. And finds his backup tight end Anthony, who was the secondary receiver in the back of the end zone.
They squib it. And it's taken by Kerwin Price. And he is knocked out of bounds. Jimmy Williams in at quarterback. He's the thrower for the Razorbacks. And Jim Nance coming up just a few moments from now at halftime. Flag down. So is Williams.
In the third quarter,
holding offense.
I think
that's the end of the first half with our score. UCLA 14, Arkansas nothing. Jim Nance back with a college football report after this message and a word from your local station. Kendall Trainer, who has kicked 23 field goals in succession. And here's the kick by Trainer. Bounces and will be taken by Brian Brown at the 1. And he gets out as far as the 21-yard line. First down. And Aikman threw it to 10 different receivers, 5 of whom are running backs. He hands it off. Sean Wills cut down at the 25-yard line. Second down and 7. Two wide receivers come way wide to the right. McCracken starts in motion, number 12, and Aikman on a spread out. This one, he'll keep. McCracken gets a little bit of a block, and Aikman is out of bounds on the first down at the 33-yard line. Aikman has passed it 18 times. He's completed 12. He has run 5. Right side, Sean Wills. Draw play, Wills. Cuts left, nifty little move, and he's out to the 42-yard line. Remember that?
All of them? I've got to memorize, yes, absolutely.
Third down and 2. Aikman goes left. He'll keep it. First down, second time he's run for one in this drive.
He's our guy.
He is going to be the number one choice. Four-man rush from the outside. Otis Lloyd.
And you did. Well done. Well done.
Second down and 18. Mike Farr starts in motion. Draw play. Wills, big hole. What a move. Out of the tackle, first down plus.
Sean Wills.
Now with 75 yards on 8 carries. First and 10, UCLA from the 33. Draw, fake the draw. And Aikman, down. Back at the 46, Ron Carricker, number 10, a junior from Morgan Hills, California, who's only thrown 7 passes this year. Draw play again, Sean Wills goes left.
Second and forever. What do you call here?
Well, you call on Andre Risen of Michigan State and send him deep like he did last night in the Gator Bowl despite the loss to Georgia. Across the middle. Is it caught in a fumble? I believe so. Yes, that is ruled a catch and a fumble.
I think it was Reggie Hall, the inside linebacker, who really...
First down, 10, Razorbacks. Second turnover for UCLA. Groby to Foster. 14-0. UCLA leads as the sun breaks through. Play fake. Groby still has it. Gets a block from Foster and is down at the 40. That'll bring up third and 2. Whistle before the play.
Got a dead ball. False start against the offense. 5-yard penalty.
And that third and 7 from the 45 of UCLA. Groby being chased, gets rid of it, and that will be close for the first down. It depends on the spot.
Huburn.
All right, John, here is Quinn Groby, who throwing the ball is now 2 of 4 for only 9 yards. That handoff to Foster gets him down to the 35-yard. They average 146 yards through the air per game. They'll hand it off to Foster on first down. See, they've had a long lead on third down throughout the afternoon. Here comes Groby on the corner, and it's almost picked off. This will be from 49 yards away. The streak continues.
Wow.
49 yards. Now, that will not extend his NCAA or school record because bowl records don't count. Here's the longest field goal in Cotton Bowl history, Greg Gant of Alabama. That was 50 yards. Look at this. Think that doesn't help the kickoff return average? First and 10, 14-3. 6:32 to go, third quarter. Sean Wills lost a yard. Aikman, 13 of 19. Moderate yardage, only 100 yards. No bombs. He's adjusted and gone underneath. He'll draw this time to Wills. Look at him break a tackle and high step again. All the way out to the 31. It was 14-0 at the half. Two long drives in the second quarter. Wills in motion. Aikman back to throw. That's not an easy pass. Second down, 7. Second and 6.
Come on, Dave.
Wills to the 41. Third and 1. Fullback Mark Estwick, number 22, the sophomore. First and 10. All kinds of movement up front. The answer is no. 3:34 to go in the first half. Aikman has 14 completions. You talk about diversifying your passing game. The 11 different receivers.
The ability to adjust is the key to winning bowl games.
Toss left, Sean Wills. Gets about three. Second down at 8. Four-man Razorback rush. Cornish put a defensive back on his back. And Estwick makes the catch to the 48. 14-3 UCLA. Third and 4. Play fake. Aikman. Caught. First down at the 39. Mike Farr. Aikman changes. Gives it off to Wills. Dances left. Driven out of bounds after a 1.5 yard gain. Second down and 8. 101 to go. Third quarter. 14-3 Bruins. Again, the sprint. That one might have one-hopped. Yes, it did. Incomplete pass. At 8.
Important down for this Razorback defense.
Blitz. And Aikman rolls out of trouble. Flag is down. Pass is caught by Moore. Folks from holding the West Coast. Wipe out the first ever because he's got 3rd and 18. UCLA has made 10 in a row third down conversions. 10 in succession. None this long. Arbuckle caught. Arbuckle might have got away with a shove. And now it's 11 in a row. The Mobile Cotton Bowl on CBS Sports will return after this message and a word from your local station. And he just converted a 3rd and 18. With a 35-yard pass, first down and 10. This is the 12th play of this drive. Draw play. Wills for 1. Second down, 9. 14-3, Bruins lead. Sacked. Ty Mason, who was just burned on the 35-yard catch by Arbuckle. 3rd and 15 officially. Left side, Lawrence Berkeley. Fumble! The Razorbacks have 45 yards of total offense in this game. Grovey pitches, and what a job defensively. Darrell Henley. Oh, it doesn't get any better. They have 34 on the ground today. Grovey from the end zone. 3rd and 12. The Razorbacks 2 of 8 third down conversions. Blitz coming. Grovey steps up and lets it go. Incomplete. Henley has had problems fielding punts today, though. And there's another line drive kick. And it goes right by him. That is the 5th consecutive time that Henley has been fooled to 13 different receivers. Hand off left side. Wills closing in on a 100-yard day as... Second down and 1. 14-3. 12:15 to go in the game. Estwick, that's a first down. Now first down 10, UCLA from the 47. 14-3. Sean Wills.
Holding, gets the offense. 10-yard penalty, still first down.
And obviously it's been filled now. 1st and 20. Sean Wills. Second and 17. Aikman to the 42. Mike Farr makes the tackle. Mike Farr overcame some adversity this year too. Had a tumor removed from his shin bone. And he goes out on third down. Aikman off balance, incomplete. One of the great stars at UCLA and in the NFL. Maggio kicks this one. Nothing that's going to cause headlines to explode, but he's really played within himself today. Here's John Bland, a new quarterback for the Razorbacks, and that catch is made, and then, nope, now they rule incomplete. No catch and fumble at Mississippi State. And here is Bland back, right side, way overthrown. They are 2 of 9 on third downs in the afternoon. Five-man rush by UCLA. Bland, left side, incomplete. He had a man wide open. The stats look great. But Henley's had enormous problems with him. Here's another line driver. And Henley, having been burned a couple of times, backs away from it. It comes to a rest at the 48-yard line. Henrietta, Oklahoma, where his mom still lives. And he has not given up the chewing tobacco. First down and 10. UCLA. Hand off. Sean Wills run. They have a second down and 7. No scoring by UCLA in this half. And Wills has been the focal point. Face mask. Second down and 2. Wills, big hole. Look at him break tackles again. And he has been replaced by Brian Brown. 14-3, under 8 minutes to go in the Mobile Cotton Bowl Classic. Well, we made the point early.
Face pass. Get the defense. 5 yards.
You know.
First and 10, Bruins. Mark Estwick, Derry Donahue, and the Bruins going after their 7th consecutive bowl victory. No team has ever done it. No coach has ever done it. Here's Brian Brown. And tackle, 3rd and 5. 14-3 lead for the UCLA Bruins. And again, they work on the clock. Brian Brown barging over left guard and inside the 15.
And they didn't necessarily score with all that, but it was a field position game.
And again, they'll work on the clock. Flag is down, and Brown is tackled at the 2. If the
play about Brian Brown, and it is the holding call against UCLA.
All right, Charlie also pick up a golf club or two. Left side, Brian Brown, 5:05. He kept it conservative for much of the fourth quarter, protecting the 14-3 lead. Brian Brown inside the 20 to the 19, and again it's LaSalle Harper with it. So the rematch for the birth of the Super Bowl next Sunday. 3rd and 17, and again UCLA elects to keep it on the ground. 16 of 18, and he will kick it out of Kirk Maggio's hold. His only misses were from 40 and 50 yards. This is from 32. It's up, and it's good. And I think Donahue feels like it might be in the bag. 3:26 remaining in the 53rd Mobile Cotton Bowl Classic. Total yardage 365 to 45 for Arkansas. And the number of plays overwhelming in favor of UCLA. That kick will finally go into the end zone and come out to the 20. And for Ken Hatfield, dreams of a reappearance next year, as they apparently are going to lose only their second ball game of the year. Jimmy Williams in at quarterback now. And he keeps his balance out to the 26-yard line a couple of years. And for Danny Ford's team, a nice way to end the season. Here's Williams getting rid of it, caught by Horton up at the 30-yard line. He has diversified his passing attack by hitting 13 different receivers. And here's a pass caught over the middle by Juju Harshaw, the fullback, number 34.
Throws the ball with tremendous accuracy and velocity, which is unusual.
Williams is down. And Jimmy Williams, the number three quarterback, on in relief of both Quinn Grovey and John Bland. Left side, that one's dropped. Derek Russell couldn't hang on. Blitz, Carnell Lake. He's got 4-4 speed. That's a production of the Fort Worth Touchdown Club for the outstanding quarterback of the year in honor of the stuff was uncovered. And he is hopeful that it's all about over. Here's Brian Brown down to the 20. Son John, Dan Petty, Jim Williams, who played for Arkansas. All of those folks at the Cotton Bowl Committee, again, another outstanding job. Here's Brown inside the 15 to the 12. Eric Bradford, number 14, with a tackle.
I mean, Terry doesn't get mentioned much with the Joe Paternos and the Barry Switzers of college football, but maybe it's about time he should be.
Seven in a row for the Bruins and Terry Donahue in his 13th season at UCLA. Donahue looking for Ken Hatfield, his counterpart for Arkansas. And there's the handshake by the two men at midfield.
We'll come back with some more thoughts on the game in just a moment.